Hey guys, welcome into the latest edition of State of the Union, a Messi edition. Gabrielle Amato alongside Jamie Easton and Eric Krakauer. And today we're going to talk about the players. I want to ask you both, who stands to benefit the most if Messi leaves? Jamie, we'll begin with you.
We've been discussing throughout the season why Griezmann didn't adapt to Barcelona. He wasn't playing where he usually plays. He wasn't playing where he was playing at Atletico or with the French national team. Even Ronald Koeman has said that he would put Antoine Griezmann in a more centered position. So obviously, Griezmann is the player that will favor most from Messi leaving. But we have to understand one thing. Koeman wants Coutinho to stay here, and I think that Coutinho can be pretty much more comfortable on the pitch without Leo Messi, and we'll see as well what will happen with Mosquito Dembele. I think that it could be an important season for those three attackers not playing with Leo Messi, liberating themselves on the pitch, feeling important and playing especially where they have to play.
Eric, for you?
I think it has to be Griezmann. Look, we know this story, right? Messi wanted Neymar to return to Catalonia. He asked the board to do something about it. Bartomeu pretended to negotiate that deal, which never came to fruition. And there was a belief and a lot of reporting, Jamie will speak to that, that Messi was a little upset that that money was spent on Griezmann and not on Neymar. And then add to that the fact that they both essentially play in the same position and the fact that Griezmann's reputation took a serious pounding this year. This is a World Cup winner. This is a guy who was a star at Atletico Madrid, the driving force behind their attack. And all of a sudden, he spends 1 year in Barcelona, and people are saying that he just simply isn't good enough for Barcelona, which is not true. Now he has an opportunity to come out of Messi's shadow and do something and rebuild his reputation. And the same can be said about Coutinho, although to a lesser extent, he returns. I think he was a little intimidated by Messi, as are a lot of players. And people have talked about the power that Messi has within the locker room, that he doesn't necessarily need to say much, but he just looks at you one way, and you know that you are not worthy. So in a way, I think this will take a weight
from a lot of players. That's what Messi was upset about, Eric. Everybody's saying the huge power he had, and every single decision of the club was made because of Leo Messi. And that's one of the things and one of the reasons why he's fed up about everything, not only because of the board and because what they are leaking into the press, but because the general feeling in the world of football that Messi has much more power than he really and actually has in Barcelona. You said what happened with Neymar. If it was for Messi, Griezmann wasn't here and Neymar was here. It's funny enough because Neymar left after seeing how after that 6-1 victory against PSG, all the front covers were for Leo Messi when Neymar was the best player of the game. Now Neymar could be the star in Barcelona. And funny enough, now Neymar has just guaranteed he will stay at PSG. It would be good times for Neymar to be in Barcelona and be the real hero now. But this is football. Things change.
Yeah, but look, but it's not about extremes, right? There is power and there is power. I'm not suggesting that Messi has power to keep Valverde, has power to make sure that Neymar arrives in Barcelona, but he certainly has power when it comes to the locker room, when it comes to playing decisions or telling at least other players that they're not playing well enough. And a lot of people have spoken, people have reported, and people within the locker room have said that this is a guy who will give you a particular look or will say something if you are not playing to the level that is expected. So I think there is an intimidation factor, whether it is intentional or not.
And do you really believe that the lineups were made by Leo Messi and not by Kike Setién?
I'm not saying that. That's not what I'm saying.
Eric, Jamie's calling you out. I want to ask you, how is the dynamic in the dressing room going to change? I mean, we talk about the players on the pitch and how their lives will change on the pitch, but how about off the pitch?
It will everything change. And if you speak with some people inside the club, I won't say names. I will only say the name of Eric Abidal. He had to leave because of that. But what he said is that they weren't training very good here because they were used to do whatever they wanted to do. The veteran players, those who have won everything. Now we'll see how this changes without Messi and probably without Suarez, without Vidal, without Rakitic, with a completely new squad. So that could change the mechanics and the dynamics of training sessions, and we could see that on the field.
Big changes to come for Barcelona all around, both on and off the pitch. We'll give you the latest, as always, on our beIN Sports USA Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook accounts.